But we continue to soldier on with chapter 9. So last time out, we got to this screen. And it seems like we got to use the Kevin block to go on a bit of a magical mystery tour, perhaps. So it's going to go across to there. But we need to be here to knock him down to go across so that we can then get through these two sections as well. Alright, this might take a bit of practice, but... because we need to be able to look at how we're going to hit this properly. And also get in the right place for this. And not stand up there. Yeah, I did kind of do this, I think, in the last time out. Obviously, I'm not sure how I did it now. Because... okay, I think I gotta go. Like that. And then hit that again. Alright, so something like that. Something like that. Marginally too slow, but about getting that positioning right on that block, I guess. And standing up at the right time, of course. And coming off the... I need to come off the analog stick as well, which is equally... Ah, I missed it. Completely missed it. Yeah, I need to be off before that. Down there. Ah, I missed it again. Let me do that. It's what I need to do. I believe. Ah. Didn't let go of the analog stick again. then I completely missed it. I wonder if it'd be better to try and get it to come down rather than across, I wonder. Possibly. So gonna hit that, I could get the dash crystal, then send it back the other way. Okay, that could be a thing. Just gotta get this first trick down. I'm just too eager on the analog stick as well at the minute, which isn't helping. Kind of felt like I hit that too early. I've got to bring it down. I have to bring it down because I need to be able to get my dash back, don't I? Hit it, then hit the dash crystal to then be able to hit it to the side, I think. Well, that still feels too early. I hesitate because I didn't think I was going to make that. Missed the second feather. Like how a duck. Jeez. Three notifications, and none of them are of interest. If I can hit that and then like just even like work my way onto the top. But I can't work my way onto the top, I have to hit the side. If I was to hit it on the side though, well, no, I still don't think my strategy is quite right. It's just like there's a missing piece and I'm not sure what that missing piece is though. Okay. That worked, whatever I did there. I mean, I missed the second lot of dash crystals, but I got there at least. Ah! Alright, we got this. We got it. Come on, boys. Let's go. The thing is, though, I'm going to get... Don't I get momentum off the Kevin block? Doesn't Kevin give me momentum? So it's how I do that jump. Oh, it's too high. Wasn't quick enough on the side hit there. Terrible. I should probably try and let go of dash on that section. Fractionally too high. Yeah, you see, that's what I mean. I've got momentum on that, because I'm travelling. I get the extra momentum to the right. Ah, I missed it. Damn. Yeah, okay. So if I jump early enough, I'll be fine. I just need to make sure I get that second dash crystal. Yeah, I knew that wasn't going to work out the minute I hit that second feather. Jumping fractionally too early. Come on, we just need to put it all together. Also need to let go of grab. As I've said so many times before, my weakness is I hold grab for all the time. Done it. Thank goodness. Praise the Lord. Oh my God, we've got wind. This should be just like timing though. Oh my goodness! How on earth did I cheese that so much? That was pretty much like holding a freaking straight line pretty much the whole way through that. That was crazy. Out of the feather, so oh boy. Ah. Man, I can't even control the feather now. I need to grab. See, that's an instance, right? Completely the opposite, where I've been trying not to hold grab, and then when I don't hold grab, I need to hold grab. It's like you just cannot win. cannot win with this game. Ever. Like a numpty. I think when I get to that point, I think I'm just going to try and grab the first block and then take my time. Not what I was doing there. It's pretty awful, I'll be honest. Get the feather again. Things happen in slow motion and you can just see them happening, but I just can't make my body react to what's about to happen, and it's frustrating. All right, so hey, what's Madeline doing here? Yeah, I was slightly out there on my timing. Shouldn't have diagonaled. Oh. Not getting that feather, and the animation of like transforming into the feather really shafted me over there. What a dash. What on earth am I doing? I'm back. I didn't ask for your help. I know, but come on, Madeline. Think this through. What's your endgame here? All that matters is finding Granny. Then maybe I can bring her home. Even if the whole universe is against me. Aren't you worried about getting lost up here? I'll figure it out. Everything's going grey. Look, Madeline. We're in space, chasing a mysterious bird. None of this is real. You're dreaming. She's gone. It's time to wake up now. But if we wake up, we'll never see Granny again. I can't believe you want her to disappear forever. You're always so selfish. First of all, it's a bird. We don't know it's her. And second of all, we need to take a step back here. No, you need to take a step back. I'm doing this, with or without you. I'm done letting you hold me back. Granny needs me. Okay. Good luck. Man, these two. Like, seriously? Oh boy. Okay. Oh my goodness. Is this going to be a screen of like... Learn the pattern blocks? Oh my god. Okay. I need to... So I think I need to wave dash off that block to make that one, then jump up from there to corner boost off the yellow one, grab onto that one, use the spring to get onto... Oh my god, how do I even get onto that one? Okay, so I use the spring at the last minute to get the double crystals, come down, dash across, dash up, dash back across onto green, jump up to there in time for that to turn to blue to use the spring. I get my dash back and get up to the top, right? Right. Oh man. I can't use a dash to get across there. because I need my dash to do the corner boost. Can I just do a straight up jump out there? Okay, that might work. Let's like grab onto the side and do it. I'm gonna have to kick it. No, I need to kick off it. Definitely need to kick off this. Yeah, okay. Okay, so I think I need to grab onto the side of the block and not onto the spring. Quite mad that the timing of like when you respawn plays quite a big part in this. Because of obviously the chime. And jump up. Ah, not gonna make that. Why on earth did I think I had a dash there? Was almost it. Sort of delaying that dash and going out to the side off that spring kind of helps a lot. Wasn't ready. I think I went too far out to the side. That wasn't my problem. Now I'm not being able to kick off this block for some reason. There we go. Fractionally too early on the jump. too late for the spring. Didn't get my upwards dashing on time. Sorry, I'm giving a running commentary, but I always find it helps if I can justify why I've done something wrong. In the wrong place. So I can make it through the gap. I was just starting to doubt myself whether I actually could. Alright, I should have gone. If I'd have used my dash, I think I would have got across. Yeah, there we go. Cool. Okay. Gotta get that button. Yeah, okay. Well, I could avoid that one. Okay, that's an interesting... Oh! Almost had it. Goodness, what is this? Double dash across. Oh my. Okay, that was almost it. But I need to probably do a diagonal up the second time around. Dashed. I shouldn't have used my dash. Oh man. Wasn't expecting to get that crystal until after, so kind of distracted me a little bit. jump to that. Can I do a single dash? Because I'm going to need a dash to go from on the last blue blocks, right? So if I can grab that double crystal, single dash into the middle of the pink. I don't know how I'm going to get through there, though, without using the double dash. I could potentially jump back the one to pink and kick off pink. Maybe. I gotta try not to get so high though, because grabbing that crystal early is bad news. But I've gotta jump high enough. So I swing some roundabouts, man. I wonder if I could dash through the bottom of the pink. Because if you dash through a block like that and you are in a block when it should be active, it stays off, doesn't it? So I'm wondering if I could manipulate that slightly. Like that. Alright, I wonder if I can... I think I've got to try and use one dash. Jump from pink to blue. And then I can dash up to the pink, wall kick over to blue. I think. Apologies. What am I doing? I'm waiting far too late. Yeah, okay. That's what I need to do. I wasn't prepared for the wall kick. Close together. I need to be high enough. It's tough. Not sure how I did that before. Almost. need enough height though to make sure I stay away from the bottom spikes on that pink block. Hitting that crystal though screws you up. I just can't get Madeline now, like, turned quick enough. Maybe I'm just dashing too early. Checking what actually happened there. Getting the height on the first, from the first crystal here, is quite important. Go far enough across. Didn't come back on myself. I jumped too early there.
Okay.
Yes. Did it. Okay. This one's relatively simple. This is all about timing. God. Okay, so that's, I think that's... Yeah, okay. Oh, I touched the frickin' electric, man. Okay. Yeah, I've got to wave dash into that one as well. To keep the dash. Slightly too early. Try using assist mode. Where's the fun in that, Eddie? What's going on there, buddy? Welcome on to stream. Hope you're well. So I need to grab that crystal. So I need to, yeah. I noticed that myself, to be honest. I mean, I'm not too bad because I have a chat bot with all my chat on this screen, but yeah, I got Twitch on this screen. And, yeah, I know I can feel your pain, man. Yeah, so I need to get... it's too close onto yellow. Piece of. I went too quickly. If you use this mode at B-side, you end up being in a band playing four stringed instruments. Was that a bass guitar? You get. I miss your hints, Eddie. Assist mode. I like it. I don't like that though. I wonder if I can skip that yellow one. Stream just repeated. He was having issues the other night, wasn't he, as well? I don't know what's going on there. Maybe Twitch don't like your hints, Eddie. How on earth did I make that, even though I haven't got a... I know. How could anybody not like your hints, man? They're what kept me going. In my hours of need. Yeah. Yeah, short-term tenancy is always about 6 months. Which is a bit sucky. I think that's just general tenancies, to be fair, Eddie. I don't think it's probably... I don't think it's just, like, you're wherever you are. Short term should be a week. Yeah, but landlords need a certain amount of stability. How can I delay this any further? Can't. Unless I have enough time to kick off that twice. A little bit above the springboard on the blue platform. Oh, you mean this one? Okay. Yeah, we could try and delay there. That was garbage. Somebody call me the rubbish man. Because I got lots of garbage. And I can't get on here quick enough. The problem with that, though, Eddie, is I've run out of stamina pretty much by the time I get to that springboard, so I have to kind of go then. And plus, that's not a very big window to aim for, is it? Alright, my other idea was to go back to pink after I've got the double dash crystal. to earlier. I was going through the block. Kick off that. I think I can get back to the pink. Unless I could do like another corner boost off that pink. Okay, that could work, because then I could maybe miss out the yellow one altogether. Okay, that could work. That could be the solution. Really? Nah, I gotta use yellow. I've not got enough. There's too much time to kill. Clever. I There we go. God. What sort of garbage is this? Can't do a freaking wave dash now. Okay. I see the bird. Almost. I should have done a diagonal. It's dead! No! Now, where's Granny? I know, what a dickhead. He killed the bird. Oh no! Are you okay? Peck, peck. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to hurt you. Restart, bird!
Restart! Restart!
Please, wait, wait, please don't leave. At least tell me. You're part of Granny, right? If you have to go, then take me with you. Madeline, stop. You can't go with her. Shut up. You couldn't force me to give up on the mountain. And you can't force me to give up on Granny. Go away. I'm not forcing you. I'm asking you. I miss Granny too. She meant a lot to both of us. Then why is it so easy for you to leave her behind? It's not easy. Maybe I pushed just to get over it too quickly. But this isn't healthy either. I just want to survive this. I know she's gone. And this is just a dream. Catching this bird won't bring her back. I'm so sorry, Madeline. Let's wake up, and we'll face this together. No. Not yet. I want to set things right first. What do you mean? The bird is trapped here because of me. We need to help it escape before we leave. Granny won't want it to be stuck like this. You're right. Let's do this. But as soon as we're done, we need to wake up. This place is so weird, I want to go home. Right. Do you ever get the feeling you're almost near the end? Okay, I think I need to get the jellyfish to launch me up. Can I throw the jellyfish through the electric? I can't remember. That would kind of make sense, I guess. Yeah. Help me, birdie. You're my only hope. There. Double dush. Yeah, we did double dush. Ha ha ha! What a dickhead! Sorry. I did exactly the same thing again. Why? Only knock. Oh. Right. You're not going to take me all the way? Fine. String keeps lagging still? Okay, well. I'm not dropping frames again, man. Oh, I haven't got a... Oh, I need to drop that. Yeah, I'm guessing you're having issues because of the 60 frames thing that I was trying to get working, so yeah, I'll probably switch it back down to 30 frames for tomorrow. Do you have a source option? I know it's like, I think the next one will only be like 480, but do you have an option to turn down the source at all, Eddie? I went to the left too quickly there. I don't think it always appears on Twitch, if I'm honest. I did read somewhere that it, depending on how many people are streaming at the time, if you're partnered with Twitch, then you always get it, but for affiliates, it can vary depending on who's on and who's doing what. So it's just luck of the draw a lot of the time, or at least it used to be. I don't know if that's still the way or whether things have changed since, like, in the last year. I didn't even jump. I thought there was a freaking spring there. I'm throwing it too quickly. Why could... Frickin' buffers. I've said this is a frick. This is actually a pretty freaking cool section. I'm really enjoying this section. Oh, I need to explode him. Yeah, it's really a cool section. Some cool freaking moves that you have to do on this. Okay, I need to hit it first once. Can't miss it, gotta hit it. Hopefully get away with that. Ah, oh, I missed the bird. One of the things that made me really like fall in love with Celeste is like the cool kind of like movement sequences you have to do. Oh, maybe the bird takes me back. Because when you pull off those movement sequences, everything just looks so cool when you put it all together. Away with that. There we go. First try hardcore. And I bet these are crumbling blocks, aren't they? Yep. Boy. How do we do this then? There we go when it's high then. Yeah, okay, that would appear to work better. This kind of feels like a frame perfect trick. That's a wave dash now. Can't get this timing down at all. That's it, okay. just wait here, I guess, and then wait till it comes low enough to dash out of there then. Too far. Oh my dear God. I don't know what's different though about like doing it now. Sometimes you're in the right position, other times you're not. I don't get it. Alright, so gotta do that. There we go. Oh, it's of course it's electrified. Of course. So I gotta... Okay. Oh, of course. Oh, man. I gotta jump out that dream block. Ow! Almost had it. Both the dashes there. Ah. If I could have just hit that dash crystal, we could have like avoided that whole spring section there. Bit like that. Alright, we could cheese this. If we can get enough height on the jellyfish. I'm not gonna be able to do that again now, am I? Of course not. There we go. That's the height I want. That was too much! What? Are you kidding? How did I cheese it? Oh. All right, I'll do. Okay, so I need to push it up. Okay. So we can hold on to that. Okay. So we could do something like that. Okay, but I think I know what I need to do. I need to kind of do it before. I think I need to push it. Something like that. I just feel like I need to catch up with the explosion. But I don't know how I can do that. I did a thing. I don't know how I did the thing, but I did the thing. And if I'd have grabbed onto the block, I would have made it across, right? I don't know, I felt like I held down, but I don't think holding down does anything. That's it. I think it's just like a very fine line of when to go and when not to go. You gotta go relatively early, but not too early. hard one to judge. Down again. So I've got to hit it in the part that will make it explode. Can't use a dash to like delay it. Just must purely be on timing, but hold right. Such a trick. It's so tricky because it is pixel perfect. I feel that I need. Maybe not. Okay. Slow it down. Makes a lot more sense. So we went there. Okay. Got to not dash there though, that's the thing. What did I just say? Ow! Fiddlesticks. What now? Oh my god! I wasn't prepared for that. I can't get through here. I don't get it. All right. I have no idea how I'm getting through that gap at all. Just totally cheesing it, I feel. Just seems that if you leave your dash late enough, you get through. Like last minute. It's almost like the block's not there. It's weird. He says. Too early. I don't know how I'm doing it again now. That's frustrating. Thank you. think I'm doing... I think the trick is just to get the block to move at the right time and the rest just happens. But yeah, I do feel like I've like cheesed it so many times, I don't really know what the proper strategy is. Hence why I've not got it in muscle memory yet. I think I got it. He says. Ow! Okay. Come on. So what I did there was I went back onto the block and I used the upwards momentum of the block to give me the extra height I needed to hit that. Okay. I forgot there as well, I got dash crystal. Am I kicked off there? I don't know. Sometimes I'm going too fast, then that time going too slow, of course. So when you overcompensate for it. My god, how did I make that? That's the first time I've ever made that without actually like doing that dash. And by dash, I mean doing the puffer fish. So, there we go. Can't go back. But I want to go back. Oh my goodness. What on earth am I meant to do here? Okay. What's going on, Jerry Nine Puzzle? Yeah. The story of Chapter 9, eh? Yeah, I can totally relate to that. It's not something I'm going to be rushing to play through a second time, that's for sure. I'm sure it'll be a lot easier the second time around, but yeah. I'm not sure I want to take that risk, to be honest. What? Madeline... Right. Goodness. What on earth was Badlin doing there? Seriously. Why am I double dashing? Am I like getting caught in between the spring? So why? If I've got to hit Madeline, why did it move the last time around? I'm confused. I'm so confused. Ah. At least we've got this, but like, down now, this... whole like all this spring and stuff. Although I went too early onto the second spring there, I feel. So they weren't close enough together, excuse me. Oh, okay. I think I've got to kind of no? Okay, so I've got to fall I didn't delay that spring. Have I got to fall down that gap? Have I got to time this like perfectly and fall down that gap? Because that would just be horrible. Nope, okay. Oh my god, and then I gotta, all right. So, I gotta do that, and then I've gotta manage this top spring. Because the bottom one gets crumbled here. Okay. Oh dear god, what have they done? Box, that's going to be interesting. Thought I had a dash there for some reason. Yeah, I know, right? Oh man, when I got to the internet cafe section, it took me forever to chain two freaking wave dashes together. Now give me a freaking wave dash end day of the week. I wonder if I have to like jump out. I wonder if I could jump over. Hold on, there might be an easier way here. There might be an easier way. No, there isn't, because I'm going to lose my dash if I do that. I don't think I'll be able to jump back over the spikes, so ignore me. Get high enough off the bottom spring. Yeah, the I'm definitely not gonna be able to grab the other side of that because A, I'm not gonna have a dash to get back across it, and B, because of the speed differential, alright, we just gotta I wouldn't say I've come across anything yet that's... I don't personally think anything on this Chapter 9 is harder than any of the seasides I did. Well, the later seasides, sorry. I went too early. Was that? It's a double crystal, but I don't know if it comes back. I just don't know how to time this. That's my biggest concern. All those levels you have, like the periscope things. At least got this first bit nailed. I'm sure I should be able to grab onto this block that's moving. I think I'm making it more difficult than it needs to be. Like a massive memory block there. Alright. Yeah, you see, that was my concern. That because it's moving forwards, I wouldn't have enough to. I haven't got enough momentum without a dash to get back in over the top of it. Oh! That was it. I think the natural angle of the spring kind of kicks you off at an upwards angle, really, doesn't it? I don't know why I haven't noticed that before. So, I just need to time my dashes into the spring right, and I will naturally clear that electric bubble. What did I dash there for? I completely changed my pattern there and it threw me out. That completely threw me out. I get right up to it and then I freaking miss it. Because, yeah, that makes sense. Oh, I should have just dashed up! Sorry. Get in. Every time I miss that last frickin' spring. No, that was too early. Struggling now. Fingers are getting into the tired zone. Yeah, I just... It's my timing more than anything. You can tell that the tiredness is kicking in my fingers because now I'm just like missing inputs for days. I think what I've got to do is I've got to hit it one side, the electric box. Go down to the spring at the bottom, get across, get the dash, hit it on the other side and go back. Which means I've gotta Well, the problem is with my clock, it's not a continuous thing for how long I've been playing the level, because for some reason when I first started playing chapter 9, I totally forgot how to save the game. It's like save at the screen, and I was like furious. I was like, why have the developers taken out the ability to save after every screen? It makes no sense. Every time I start the stream, I've got to start from a mountain checkpoint and I've got to do all this progress again, blah 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 blah. And I was talking to somebody else and they're like, well, you could just use save and quit on the pause screen. So for the first probably 3 hours of my chapter 9 playthrough is not part of my actual clock on here. I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm still going to have spent quite a considerable amount of time on this. Should we have a look? So without, I know obviously it's not a true representation, but we're at coming up to 13 hours. So we're probably at about 16, 17 hours in total. But yeah, the first couple of days I was playing this, it was really rough. It's like, just been that long since I played Celeste. I just forgot how to save at the screen. I honestly thought, when I originally played the campaign, that it just saved when you went out to the map, so I was just selecting return to map every time. But like I say, I was getting quite furious with the fact that I thought that the developers had changed it, and I was like, I can't believe they've changed it. Why would they do this? These levels are hard and they're making you having to redo everything over and over again. And it was one of the best features of Celeste that you could save at any screen. And I was like, rah, 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 rah. And then, yeah, like I said, I was talking to somebody else. They were just like, dude, just you save and quit. Oh, dear. Do that because I've already proved out that I can't grab that. I didn't think I was going to make it, so I kind of didn't commit to it. I kind of backed out of it to an extent. this is a bumper episode tonight. I've only been doing sort of an hour and a half, 2 hours. We're already up to like 2 hours and 40 in this episode. Well, 2:35. Oh, I had it then. I freaking had it. I'm sure the developers were lovely and nice in the final room, right? I can't imagine that the developers are going to be horrible in any way, shape, or form of what they have done in the final room, I'm sure. Oh, and I missed the freaking crystal! Come on, we're getting there. I feel like we're close. I mean, I don't want to know exactly how far away from the final room I am, but am I pretty close to the final room? If I hadn't have done that quick dash there, I think I would have, my time would have been right. I'm worried that I get too close to that, but I need to remember the natural kind of curvature of that spring pushes you in a diagonal anyway. Yeah, I agree. I thought I was close earlier on in the episode when I got to the alternating coloured blocks, thinking, oh yeah, it's like a like the end of a B-side. Must be close now. And then when I started to see Madeline, I was like, yeah, I definitely got to be close now, right? Still here. I didn't think it was too bad. There was one particular room that was a bit of a pain in the ass, but I thought the coloured room could, the colour blocks could have been a lot more. Alright, come on, Nock. Come on. Yes! I thought it could have been a lot more difficult. Oh my goodness. Gotta do it. I've gotta set up for that wave dash while I'm in the air. And then I guess I gotta do like a corner boost onto that spring. Yeah. I gotta do another one. Oh my goodness, this room is horrible. It's quite hard because you haven't got that dash originally. You gotta really time that like to perfection. Just hold on a minute, let me pull out my task bot. It can do it for me. Pull one of those 90s turbo pads, that's what I need, just to spam the button for me. Ow. Yeah, doing that, doing a double dash there. It's already a TAS out. Obviously, I've been trying to kind of like avoid spoilers and things, so I've really not been watching any of like the streamers I follow who I normally watch for Celeste videos until I've been finishing this. I can imagine the TAS is insane though. I think it was the last TAS run I watched of Celeste was, I think it was at this year's GDQ, and I think it was like an all berry run, and my goodness, there may as well just not have been any spikes on Summit at all. It was insane. The amount of demo dashes like the TAS bot did through the freaking spikes. My goodness, look at me go. Ow! Alright, I was pretty impressed with myself doing that. Ah. I've got to get a wave dash though. I've got to get on to try and get on top of those other blocks, I guess. Tough though. time are we at? 10 to 12. Right, another 10 minutes. Be nice if I could beat the screen before the... Oh, and I've got to do a wave dash off there, of course. Yes. Yeah, I suffered from that so much in my original playthrough. I fat finger so many inputs. Are you kidding? Oh my goodness. What else am I doing? I gotta drop a little bit. I freaking hate the feather. I've got to time that jump perfectly, or else I'm going to lose the spring. Interesting. I said earlier on in the stream, though, some of these screens, they're really annoying, but the movement tech in the screens, to me, they feel really rewarding when you actually pull them off, because the room just looks so cool when you watch it back. One thing I do like about it, as much as levels make you rage, sometimes it's really nice just to sit back and like watch them be done in like a fluid motion. Oh man, you've got a really short jump, haven't you? But I need to be far enough on... Say I've got a short jump, but I've got to be far enough on that last one to get enough distance on the spring. So it's really difficult to judge, actually. There we go. I'm glad the music's... I'm enjoying the music a lot more. There was one section early on, and I just really hated the music. It was like... It was like I was at a wedding or something. It was like really ceremonial music. But I feel like later on in the game, later on in this chapter, the music's kind of like returned back to the Celeste roots, so I'm really quite happy in a way. You kind of get that original Celeste feel with this. Yeah, I actually killed the music and actually had on the original soundtrack for quite a while during that section. I just absolutely hated it. I said to the people in the stream at the time, I said, I'm not being funny, but it sounds like I'm at a wedding. We've got a couple more minutes. Come on. I probably should have called it at the end of the last screen, but... I just can't help myself. Oh my goodness, I gotta dash up. Nailed it. Boom! Take that, Windy Whip. No! Oh boy. That would have been hilarious. It really wouldn't have been hilarious, but that would have been hilarious. Let me clip that. Is that the right place to clip? I never know, really know how the clipping works and stuff. Yeah, it's the right thing. It really wouldn't have been hilarious though. That serves me right. Serves me right for prattling around, man. All right, well, all right. I'm gonna leave it there, guys. Thank you very much for tuning in tonight. I really appreciate the support. We will be back tomorrow with some more Chapter 9 Celeste. Maybe we'll get to actually finish it tomorrow. We'll have to wait and see. But until then, once again, thank you very much for everybody tuning in and everybody's support. I've been Nock. You've been awesome. See ya.